Make it a resolution or not, building a healthier lifestyle is always good goal for any time of the new year. And sometimes that just means changing a few things in your daily routine instead of making big sweep changes. Here to give us some good ways to start is Dr. Zoe Stalling. She's a family medicine physician with primary care at Pomona and a member of Cone Health Medical Group. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
I feel like people always talk about the new year and making those resolutions and losing weight and may set out something that's too large and get overwhelmed.
Right.
But a big part of that is making sure that you're healthy to do so. So you should probably talk to your doctor beforehand.
Absolutely. You know, when we encourage our patients to come on in, get a checkup early in the year, set those goals, we actually do goal setting appointments. In that physical exam, we check your cholesterol, thyroid. We want you to be successful. So getting that initial physical exam is a great way to emphasize what you need to work on in terms of your risk management portion, as well as what you want to be successful in for the rest of the year. So get in a checkup before your plans start so that you don't injure yourself when you start to exercise is a key factor. We also encourage people to come on in so that we look at your family history.
Sure.
Are many members in your family diabetic? What about polycystic ovarian syndrome that makes it difficult to lose weight? We don't want you to fail, and many people fail and feel like, I just can't do this.
Right.
But with the help of a team, we can actually talk about what things we can approach and how best to take care of those things and a general physical exam.
In making that plan, you should probably look at diet and exercise, but your family history, that's a good point, may have a lot to do with what you should do physical, because everyone says 30 minutes a day, but how rigorous that can depend on your level.
Exactly. It's never one size fits all. It's always a personalized plan. And then your primary care doctor can look at the trends. They can see that, you know, I noticed that since you've started this new career path, you're more sedentary.
Right.
So even if you can break it up to 10 minutes in the morning and 10 minutes in the middle of the day, that might be better. You may not be the person who can go biking all weekend.
That's true.
So it's important to set those attainable goals. And then also at our practice, we have the ability to determine when do you need referral to a specialist.
Okay.
You know, if you're struggling with diabetes and morbid obesity, we don't want you to continue. You could have effects on your joints. So at primary care at Pomona, we talk to people about, well, you know, we see that your joints are getting weaker. We might need to get you some injections so you can tolerate exercise. So working with your primary care physician is a great way to just come up with a plan that works with you. And then what is the best way to be successful at those things?
And that's a person who's licensed to hold you accountable as well. It's not just a friend telling you or pushing you to do something. They're looking out for you as well. And lastly, of course, we talked about oral hygiene. A lot of people may not think about it, but in that exam, that's really important to make sure that you're keeping healthy as well.
Exactly. When your primary care doctor or primary care nurse practitioner or provider says, open up and say, ah, we're looking inside your mouth because a lot of overall health starts there. And then your dentist screens for oral cancers. They can actually detect rheumatologic problems. If your saliva is a different quality, they can say, you know, I think you might need to see a specialist for connective tissue disorders. So the mouth is very important. It's essential to get that good health. Many people don't even eat the right food because of pain from dental disease. And it can affect your heart too.
Right.
Certain bacterial infections in the mouth can really affect the heart. So we want you to get your checkups. And some people who have no dental insurance, we talk about different ways in our setting, in the primary care setting, that you can get that dental health, whether it's through charity care or some of the dental schools that provide that care.
That's really important. I think this is the time to open that conversation.
Yes.
There are no bad questions, especially with your doctor, and about your own health.
Exactly.
Right.
When you walk into that doctor's office and that door is closed, that is your private space to discuss the things that bother you. What are your hindrances? What are the things that you've been nervous about? What did you Google? What are those things you saw on Facebook that you think really affect you?
Right.
Rather than you having that anxiety and nervousness all on your own, bring it to us. We can talk about it and package it into portions that we can handle. Some things can't all be done at the same visit, but we can work on follow-up visits and what do we do next.
And that'll be a great start for the new year. Thank
Absolutely.
You so much for coming
Thank you.
To find out more about healthy lifestyle resources that can help you through the new year, as well as coming up in classes, check out conehealth.com/wellness-matters.